Okay, then let's kick off today's show with today's global headlines. 세계 각국 언론사들의 어떤 헤드라인이 올라왔는지 살펴보는 시간입니다. Touch Global Headlines.
Poland's Olga Tokarczuk and Austria's Peter Handke have won the Nobel Prize in Literature for 2018 and 2019, respectively.
올해와 작년 노벨 문학상의 영예는 오스트리아의 페터 한드케와 폴란드의 올가 토카르추크에게 각각 돌아갔습니다.
Tensions are escalating between Washington and London after the wife of a U.S. diplomat allegedly caused the death of a British teenager and was granted diplomatic immunity so she could flee the U.K.
영국에서 차량 사망 사고를 낸 미국 외교관의 부인이 면책특권을 앞세워 출국해버린 사건으로 인해 두 나라 사이에 긴장감이 감돌고 있습니다.
Iraq's Prime Minister has pledged swift changes within the government, such as a cabinet reshuffle in efforts to quell anti-government protests.
이라크 총리가 전국 곳곳에서 이어진 반정부 시위와 관련해 내각 개편과 부패 청산을 위한 개혁을 약속했습니다.
More than 2,000 people have been arrested in Hong Kong since protests against a controversial extradition bill began.
홍콩 송환법 반대 시위로 경찰에 체포된 시위대가 2,000명을 넘어선 것으로 나타났습니다.
Scientists have announced that the northern hemisphere suffered its hottest summer on record.
올여름 북반구를 휩쓴 폭염으로 역대 최고 기온 신기록이 쏟아졌습니다.
Well, for more on these stories, we have Steve Hatherley in the studio. Good morning, Steve.
Good morning to you. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday. How are you today?
I'm good, and I'm thinking about food now,
yeah,
because of your opening, and more specifically about Korean food. I still remember my very, very first Korean dish.
What was it?
It was on the airplane.
Ah.
Coming from Chicago to... Mm-hmm. Not Incheon at that time. There was no Incheon International Airport
Gimpo,
at that time.
Right?
It was Gimpo, yeah. I had bibimbap and miyokguk on the airplane.
Wow.
And it was interesting because...
How did you like it?
Well, when I came to Korea for the first time, I had no idea about Korean food. I mean, literally zero.
What brought you to Korea in the first place?
Well, I was a little bored with my work at home. I had a nice career path in front of me, but I wasn't satisfied with my life, and a friend had moved over here, so I decided to follow suit.
But you knew nothing about the cuisine?
No, I knew nothing about the country.
Okay.
I'm on the plane, and the flight attendant says to me, would you like this dish or this dish? But, you know, not knowing any Korean language or any Korean foods, it sounded like bup, 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 or bup, bup, bup. So one of the options was bibimbap.
Yeah.
So I chose that. I said, I'll have that one, please. So anyway, I open it up, and I say, oh, this looks quite good. You know, there's rice and there's
colorful
vegetables.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's aesthetically pleasing as well. But then there's the little toothpaste tube of gochujang.
Which is very popular now, by the way.
Gochujang?
The tube version of that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, people gift it to others because it's so convenient.
It is. So, but I didn't know
Did
what
you
it
think
was.
Think it was toothpaste?
Probably.
Yeah.
So I look around, right, because there's so many Korean people on the flight, so I'm looking for help. So I look around and people are opening up the toothpaste tube and emptying in their gochujang. So I do the same thing.
Oh,
and I
the whole thing?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Well, I didn't know what to do, and I took a bite and my mouth was on fire, and then so, oh my goodness, okay, so I can't eat this, so I pushed it aside and I said, okay, what else do we have? And I pull over the little bowl, the plastic bowl, and I open it up, and it's miyokguk.
Yeah.
And I looked at it and I thought, it's a plant in water. What do I do with this? Do I water it, or do I fertilize it, or do I eat it? I'm not sure. But anyway, that was my very first Korean meal experience, and now I eat bibimbap very well, thank you, and I eat miyokguk very well, thank you. It was just my initial experience.
Oh, how long ago was that?
19 and a half years ago.
Almost 20 years.
Yeah.
Wow. 20여 년 전에 처음으로 비빔밥과 미역국을 드셨을 때 이렇게 좀 충격을 많이 받았다는 얘기를 해주셨는데요. 미역이 우리나라에서는 굉장히 흔한 음식이지만 외국에선 거의 먹지 않잖아요. 그래서 even the name for 미역 in English is seaweed.
Right.
그러니까 직역을 하면 바다 잡초.
Uh-huh. And we eat seafood in, or seaweed in Nova Scotia too.
Oh, you do.
Yeah, but it's purple.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, and we eat it dried, and it's very salty. It's like a snack, yeah.
Yeah, well, they say the health benefits of seaweed are so great, especially for mothers who've just given birth. Mm-hmm. So in Korea, all mothers who've just given birth will have seaweed for months and months, and people around the world are now following
oh,
that.
Oh, cool.
Because they realize it's really good for you.
And on your birthday, you're supposed to eat miyoku.
Yes.
What's the cultural reason for that? Do we know? Someone can text it in. What's the cultural reason for eating miyokguk on your birthday?
Mm, I'd like to know. Let us know. Yeah. All right. Apparently, our writer's just written in. It's related to what I just told you, how mothers always have miyokguk when they give birth.
Mm.
So on your birthday, you're paying tribute to your mother.
Ah, that's cool. I like that.
Yeah, because in Korea, everything is about relationships. Your birthday is not really your day.
Yeah, right.
It's the day you remember your mother,
uh-huh.
in Korea at least.
I see. Interesting. Yeah. That's new information for me.
네. 주민지님이요. 오랜만에 버스 타고 출근 중입니다. 44번에 타자마자 스티브 쌤 목소리가 들려서 놀랐어요. 그런데 너무 볼륨이 낮아서 잘 안 들리네요. 기사님, 볼륨 좀 높여주세요. 라고 보내셨습니다. 네, 기사님 혹시 듣고 계시면은요. 오늘도 정말 고생 많으시고 수고 많으십니다.
Turn us up on the bus.
볼륨 조금만 올려 주세요.
Yeah,
감사합니다.
Right.
All right. Well, if you'd like to listen to the headlines again, you can do so by visiting our website. Let's go over the headlines.
Headline number one this morning, Poland's Olga Tokarczuk and Austria's Peter Handke have won the Nobel Prize in Literature for 2018 and 2019, respectively.
네, 올해와 작년 노벨 문학상의 영예는 오스트리아의 페터 한트케와 폴란드의 올가 토카르추크에게 각각 돌아갔습니다.
Yep, so these were given out yesterday,
yep.
and it's a rare double announcement, right? It was for 20...
First time.
Yeah, it was for 2018 and 2019, and the reason it was a double announcement this year is because there was no literature prize awarded last year. There were sex abuse allegations that kind of rocked the Swedish Academy, and so they decided to put that off, and that's why there was the double announcement
right.
this year.
To be clear, it wasn't a direct effect, and none of the members of the committee were directly related to this sex scandal that happened last year, but the wife of the main person in question was a member of the Nobel Committee. And, and normally, if you're on the committee, especially we're looking at the Literature Prize Committee, you're given that post for life. And so people questioned the whole legitimacy of this regulation. You know, you have a post for life, but then if you embroiled in some sort of corruption, what
right.
do you do?
Yeah.
And since then, a lot of people resigned on the board. That's why they weren't able to nominate anyone last year. And now they have new regulations. It's a lot more transparent.
I see. And the reason it was just for literature is because there are different judges for different prizes,
of course.
Right?
Yeah. I mean, experts
yeah.
choose the winners.
So let's talk about the winners a little bit.
Yep.
Peter Handke, he was called by the Swedish Academy one of the most influential writers in Europe. He's 76 years old, but he's been criticized a lot and for a long time for his vigorous defense of the Serbs during the 1990s wars that devastated the Balkans as Yugoslavia disintegrated. And it's interesting, too, that he once called for the Nobel Prize to be abolished.
Mm-hmm.
So he won the prize
yeah.
that he called for the abolishment of.
그러게요. 자, 그래서 2019년 수상자로 상을 받게 된 페터 한트케 얘기를 지금 해주셨는데요. 약간 논란의 중심이 되고 있습니다. 그 구 유고슬라비아의 리더였던 밀로소비치의 지지자였는데 밀로소비치가 이제 대량 학살로 잘 알려진 인물이죠. 그래서 그런 배경으로 인해서 좀 비판을 받는 작가이기도 하고 그다음에는 예전에 노벨 문학상 이런 거 필요 없다라고 말했던 인물이기도 하기 되기 때문에 이번에 이제 수상을 한 것에 대해서 약간의 논란이 있습니다만 but nonetheless he did win the 2019 award.
He did along with Olga Tokarczuk. She is is a 57-year-old novelist, mm-hmm. and she's known for her humanist themes, and the Academy said that she was chosen for works that explore the crossing of boundaries as a form of life. She's already a major figure in Poland, and she's also building her international profile, too, because she won the Booker International Prize in 2018 for her novel Flights.
그렇죠. 이미 저명한 작가이기도 한데요. 이번 여성 작가가 선정된 것에 대해서 호평이 쏟아지고 있습니다. How many female prize winners have there been in the literature category?
Well, she's only the 15th woman to win the Nobel Literature Prize in the history of all the prizes given out. But of the 11 Nobels awarded so far this week, she's the only woman to have won.
그렇습니다. 이번에 이제 15번째로 여성 수상자가 됐습니다. 이 노벨 문학상에 있어서요. But this has been going on for more than 100 years. So we hope to see more female winners. That is the right direction we're headed in. And so, yeah, two winners this year.
Yeah, and if you're looking for a good couple of reads, then yeah, look no further than the two winners for the prizes given out to Nobels for Literature this
year. Yeah, and the upcoming announcement, Friday local time, so this evening Korea time,
Peace
will be
prize.
For the Peace Prize. I wonder who's going to win that one.
Everybody's looking forward to seeing that.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's go on to headline number two.
All right, so tensions are escalating between Washington and London after the wife of a U.S. diplomat allegedly caused the death of a British teenager and was granted diplomatic immunity so she could flee the UK.
영국에서 차량 사망 사고를 낸 미국 외교관의 부인이 면책 특권을 앞세워 출국해 버린 사건으로 인해 두 나라 사이에 긴장감이 감돌고 있습니다.
So Harry Dunn was the teenager. He was 19 years old and he was killed when his motorcycle crashed into a car on August 27th. So this happened back in late August and the suspect in the case is 42-year-old Anne Sekulis. She is reportedly married to a U.S. intelligence official who was granted diplomatic immunity following the crash. Now, Boris Johnson has called President Donald Trump to personally ask him to reconsider the U.S. position to grant immunity to this American woman suspected of being involved in the death of Harry Dunn.
Mm-hmm. But she is in America.
She's in America, yeah.
Looks like she has no plan to go back to the UK. Now, the car was driving on the wrong side of the road.
For about 400 meters, it said.
So, I mean, I can, you know, kind of understand, to be the devil's advocate, I can understand how an American might be mixed up with that. However, she committed a crime, and alleged crime, I should add, because at this point in time, there's a lot of evidence that points to her. But, you know, we haven't been able to see any real investigation go on.
And she spoke with the police, but after that, her family fled the country, and they are back in America now. And this is a major point in this case, because diplomatic immunity was awarded to Mrs. Sekulis because her husband was an intelligence official.
Yep.
But the interesting thing is that he didn't appear on the list of diplomats in the UK with immunity, but he was granted, she was granted immunity anyway.
자, 그래서 영국에서 19세의 Harry Dunn이라고 하는 청년이 교통사고로 인해서 사망을 했습니다. 오토바이를 타고 있었고요. 상대 차량은 차선, 아니, 그 완전히 차선을 다르게 탄 게 아니라 그러니까 영국에서는 이제 왼쪽에서 운전을 해야 돼요. 운전자가 오른쪽에 있고요. 그러니까 우리랑 완전 정반대라고 생각을 하시면 되겠지만 그 미국인 여성 운전자는 그냥 한국이랑 미국처럼 오른쪽 차선에서 달리고 있었던 거예요. 그래가지고 중앙 차선에서 기준으로 봤을 때 이제 오른쪽으로 달리고 있었는데 부딪혀서 결국은 충돌을 하고 이제 Harry Dunn 는 사망을 했습니다. 근데 이 여성이 미국 외교부 산하 직원의 와이프라는 이유로 면책 특권이라는 게 부여가 됐다고 해요. 그로 인해서 사망 사건에 연루된 인물이었지만 영국을 아무 걸림돌 없이 떠날 수 있었던 겁니다. 근데 이제 미국에 가 있으니까 영국에서는 이렇게 쉽게 데려올 수도 없는 거예요. 자발적으로 와야 되는데 가지 않겠다고 합니다.
They want her to come back to the UK to deal with this. I believe President Trump either commented or passed a note to someone saying that that was not going to happen.
And he also said something about this particular case that driving on the wrong side of the road can happen. I don't know how you can say something like that when someone has died.
Seems a bit insensitive. Actually, it seems very insensitive. Anyway, the family, Harry Dunn's family, met with Foreign Secretary Dominic Raab. They were not happy with that meeting. They called it a publicity stunt. And if she does not return to the UK, Harry Dunn's family will be looking at a civil suit, lawsuit against the wife of the diplomat in America. Because in America, there's no more diplomatic immunity if they are in the United States.
그렇죠. 그래서 이제 미국의 법에 따르면은 이렇게 외교부 산하 외교부가 소속된 직원들의 경우에는 그 가족까지도 다 다른 나라에서 어떤 범죄와 연루됐을 때 면책 특권이라는 게 주어진다고 합니다. 그래서 자국으로 빨리 돌아올 수 있게끔 하는 원래는 좋은 취지의 법인데요. 이로 인해서 지금 영국에서 사망 사고를 낸 한 미국 직원의 아내가 미국으로 이를테면 이제 도망을 간 셈이죠. 사실 뭐 그냥 돌아갔다라고 얘기를 하고 있지만 그래서 지금 영국에서는 어떤 조치를 취하려고 하냐면은 그렇다면 미국에서 사건을 담당할 변호사를 찾고 있다 이렇게 얘기를 하고 있더라고요.
And I should correct myself because I said the wife of the diplomat. Incorrect. The wife of the intelligence official because again he's not on the list of diplomats with immunity.
Yeah. Okay, well this is not going to help relations between the US and the UK. Let's go on to headline number 3.
Iraq's prime minister has pledged swift changes within the government such as a cabinet reshuffle in efforts to quell anti-government protests.
이라크 총리가 전국 곳곳에서 이어진 반정부 시위와 관련해 내각 개편과 부패 청산을 위한 개혁을 약속했습니다.
So Iraqi Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi announced a cabinet reshuffle. He also declared 3 days of national mourning and he said that those who shot protesters would be punished. He was seeking to quell anti-government unrest and this has been going on in Iraq for days all over the country.
This has to do with the youth unemployment rate we mentioned a few days ago, right?
The youth unemployment rate, water is a big issue here as well. Authorities, they are fearing that violence, which by the way has now killed more than 110 people, mostly protesters, angry at the government corruption. They're trying to solve this problem as quickly as they can. However, this package of reforms announced by the government, and the reforms would include more job opportunities, subsidies on housing, it's unlikely to satisfy the protesters, nor is the cabinet reshuffle, because they say that the cabinet reshuffle will feature many of the same faces that the protesters are unhappy with at the moment.
네, 실업난 그리고 수도 또 전기가 같은 이제 공공 서비스 문제를 해결하기 위해서 시위대가 이달 초부터 계속해서 시위를 하고 있습니다. 그런데 벌써 뭐 일주일 만에 한 100여 명이 사망을 했다고 하고요. 이에 대해서 이라크 총리가 앞으로는 이제 개혁을 하겠다 이렇게 약속을 한 모습입니다. I hope there will be no more deaths and they will move forward. Let's go on to our next headline.
Headline number 4. More than 2,000 people have been arrested in Hong Kong since protests against a controversial extradition bill began.
홍콩 송환법 반대 시위로 경찰에 체포된 시위대가 2천 명을 넘어선 것으로 나타났습니다.
Yeah, it's been 4 months now, hasn't it? 18 consecutive weeks since the start of the protests. Hong Kongers are becoming all too familiar with this. It's becoming the new norm, it seems. More than 2,000 people have been arrested. And if you think back, you know, to the very first day of when this started, which I believe was June 9th of this year, 1 million people were out in the streets and they were peaceful protests and it was against the extradition bill. But now, 4 months later, here we are. And that event seems like a distant memory, does
right.
it not?
If we break down the 2,000 or so people arrested, under 18s account for one-third of that number. 이 전체 2,300여 명이 지금 체포가 된 상태인데요. 홍콩에서 그 중에 3분의 1인 750명 정도가 18세 이하 미성년자라고 합니다. 특히 16세 이하도 100명이 넘는다고 하거든요. The second in chief of Hong Kong has said that this is heartbreaking to see so many youngsters involved in the case. You can see this both ways about the involvement itself and also about arresting so many underage children.
Yeah, it is tragic, of course. And the protesters, though, did not stop after Carrie Lam withdrew the extradition bill. Because they have 5 demands in total. The withdrawal of the extradition bill, that was one, but an independent inquiry into the use of force by police is another. amnesty for arrested protesters, a halt to describing the protests as riots, excuse me, and the implementation of universal suffrage in Hong Kong. So when Carrie Lam withdrew the extradition bill, they said the protesters' response was 5 demands, not one less.
네, 아직도 끝이 보이지 않는 홍콩 시위입니다. 이렇게 지난 몇 달 동안 2천여 명이 체포된 가운데 3분의 1이 미성년자라는 사실에 대해서 홍콩 부총리는 굉장히 가슴 아프다 이런 얘기를 했습니다. Let's go on to our final headline.
Scientists have announced that the northern hemisphere suffered its hottest summer on record.
올여름 북방부를 휩쓴 폭염으로 역대 최고 기온 신기록이 쏟아졌습니다.
Did you realize that 90% of the population of Earth lives in the northern hemisphere?
Is that right?
Yeah, I did not realize that. And that's where all five of its warmest summers have occurred in the last five years.
Wow.
Yeah, the northern hemisphere just went through its hottest summer on record. That's according to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. They announced that on Monday.
이번에 그 역대 최고 기온 신기록이요. 400개 이상이 세워졌다고 합니다. More than 400 record-breaking heat, I suppose, heat-related records were achieved or broken across Europe.
Yeah, record.
And across the northern hemisphere, rather.
Yeah, exactly. Record warm temperatures during that three-month period. Western coast of Alaska, Mexico, western and southern Africa, South America, Europe, Asia, and also Africa just had its warmest June to August record as well.
네, 총 29개국에서 이렇게 거의 400개 최고 기온 신기록이 수립됐습니다. All right, so those were our headlines for this morning. It's not hot anymore, but what is the quiz?
Quiz question today. Something especially rare or expensive that is good to eat can be referred to as, number one, a delicacy, or number two, a democracy.
짧은 문자 50원, 긴 문자 100원에 샵 1045로 보내주시고요. 반디 게시판이나 카카오톡 플러스 이용도 가능합니다. 추첨을 통해서 총 다섯 분께 오늘 준비한 상품 보내드리도록 하겠습니다. All right, we're going to listen to a song, and when we come back, we will take a look at our news focus stories. Our first song of the day today is Myra Malmberg with Stars in the Sky.
Crazy.
And that just there was Swedish singer Myra Malmberg's Stars in the Sky. That's a nice song, wasn't it, to start
nice,
the day off?
Nice and soft in the morning, yeah?
All right, let's take a look at your messages. 조주희 님이요. 제가 가장 추천하고 싶은 한국 음식은 해물파전, 그리고 막걸리, 묵무침입니다. 대학생 때 외국인 친구가 저의 현란한 부침개 뒤집기 신기술을 보고 어찌나 신기해 하던지요. 라고 보내주셨습니다. Are you impressed when people are able to flip their 파전s or 부침개s?
Yeah, the giant pancakes.
Yeah, they're so big and quite heavy as well.
My sister enjoyed that when she visited here, and she loved makgeolli.
Did she?
She really loved it, yeah.
Oh, 네. Oh, apparently a little bluebird tells me you're a great cook. Is that true?
I try.
Oh, wow. Yeah. What do you like to cook?
Oh, I like to experiment. Yeah.
What's the most recent thing you cooked then?
Oh, I'd have to look at my Instagram pictures to remember the most recent thing that I cooked. But yeah, I like to try different things.
Wow.
Oh, I remember. I had seafood weekend. Mm. So I went out and I bought some hongap, right? And I made this steamed mussels with and then the sauce I made was garlic and white wine and blue cheese.
That's like a French cuisine, isn't
it? Yeah. And then the following day I had some shellfish left over, so I made like a clam linguine.
Oh, 너무 맛있었겠네요.
Yeah, it's pretty good, yeah.
네, 그 프랑스 고급 요리 중에 이렇게 그 좀 오목한 그릇에다가 홍합을 엄청 많이 수십 개 넣어놓고 그 다음에 와인 소스랑 같이 이렇게 버무려서 먹는 게 있는데 그걸 집에서 만들어서 드셨어요?
Yeah, if you are going to cook with wine, if you want to make mussels that way, make sure that you boil the alcohol out of the wine. Otherwise, you might be a little tipsy after your 홍합.
Yeah, you don't want cold wine in there.
Yeah, right.
네, 알코올 성분은 다 날아가게끔 끓여서 먹는 요리입니다. 이정하님이요. 지금 생각나는 한국 음식 저는 누룽지가 생각나요. 속풀이 해장에도 좋고 찬바람 솔솔 부는 요즘 같은 아침에 먹기 참 좋은 음식입니다. 해장에 좋아요. 라고 보내주셨습니다.
누룽지 is so good with 불닭.
아, 그래요?
Yeah.
Oh, I've never had the two together.
Because the heat of the 불닭 is so intense, but then you take a little bit of 누룽지 after that, right?
Why not just not eat 불닭 if you can't manage the heat?
맛있으니까요.
That's what I do. I don't have. I've never had 불닭.
Because the heat is so satisfying.
Really?
Right? Yeah, you get that.
The irony. Yeah,
you don't like spicy.
You're more Korean than I am.
Yeah, some people
I've
say
never
that.
Had it. Yeah.
You don't like spicy food?
Not really. Well, if it's too spicy, like 불닭, then no. I like a bit of a kick in my food.
Yeah, I'll get you a toothpaste tube of gochujang then from the airplane.
Well, we have 5 저자극 순한 비누s to give out in the first hour. Keep sending in your messages. In the meantime, let's take a look at our news focus stories. 자, 첫 번째 news focus입니다. 시리아에서 미군의 지상군 역할을 했던 쿠르드족이 미군이 떠난 뒤 터키의 공격을 받으며 풍전등화의 위기에 내몰렸습니다. 쿠르드족은 나라 없는 세계 최대 민족 또는 중동의 집시로 불리는데요. Let's listen to the story.
U.S. President Donald Trump defended his decision to pull out U.S. troops from Syria by noting the Kurds were fighting for their own lands. The Kurds are an ethnic minority group totaling roughly 25 to 30 million people, all united by a unique race, culture, and language. Although Kurds are the largest ethnic minority in Turkey, making up roughly 20% of the population, they are not recognized as a minority group in Turkey. Today, Kurdistan is made up of 5 different regions, southeastern Turkey, northeastern Syria, northern Iraq, northwestern Iran, and southwestern Armenia, and is now one of the world's largest stateless nation whose people have no official homeland or country.
네, 뭐 정확한 통계는 없습니다만 2천만 명에서 4천만 명 사이, 뭐 3천이라고 칩시다. 3천만 명 정도의 소수민족인데요. 사실 소수민족이라고 하기에는 굉장히 많은 인구고요. 4개의 나라에 걸쳐서 지금 쿠르드족이 살고 있습니다. They were promised a land of their own at one point in history, but they never got that.
Yeah,
so now they're landless, nationless.
It's incredible, isn't it, to know that 25 to 30 million people can be without a state or without a country. And they are a huge ethnic minority group.
Mm-hmm, 그렇습니다. Turkey doesn't recognize this group as an ethnic group, though.
No, they don't. And to speak about ethnics is to speak about your cultural group or your race, right? So if someone was to grow up in the United States, Korean American, for example, and someone were to ask, you know, oh, are you Japanese or are you Chinese or something like that? And you can answer, no, I'm ethnically Korean, meaning that's the cultural group that I belong to.
Right. And if you are an American citizen, you say, but I'm American.
Exactly.
네. 그래서 어떤 민족에 속해 있을 때 ethnic라는 표현을 쓸 수 있고요. 실제로 이렇게 미국에서 살고 있는 한국인 같은 경우에는 I'm ethnically Korean. 근데 이제 미국 시민이다. 예를 들자면 그러면은 but I'm American 이렇게 얘기를 할 수 있겠죠. All right, what's another expression in here?
Mm-hmm. So Kurdistan is now made up of five different regions. So to make something up of, it means it's consisting of. So what is, let's use the example of miyeokguk. What is it made up of? Well, it's, actually, I don't know the recipe for miyeokguk. It's made up of miyeok and?
And it depends. You can put beef in there.
Okay.
You can put seaweed in there. Uh-huh. Or you can even put... fish
okay.
or some other sort of, you know, sea-based.
So let's use that as the example then. Okay. Oh, what's this dish made up of? Mm, what does it consist of?
Yeah.
Miyeokguk is made up of seaweed, beef, and fish.
Yes. 네, the make, made up of 뭐뭐뭐 하면은 이렇게 이루어져 있다라는 뜻이 되겠고요. 커디스탄이라고 지금 부르는 게 자치구인데 국가는 아닙니다. 그래서 이제 다섯 개의 지역으로 나뉘어져 있다라는 뜻으로 설명을 할 수 있겠습니다. Morning special is made up of a large crew. It's not just you and me.
Yeah.
There's lots of people outside as well. So we are made up of many, many people.
And also we are made up of many different guests and many different segments.
That is true. Let's listen to the story one more time.
U.S. President Donald Trump defended his decision to pull out U.S. troops from Syria by noting the Kurds were fighting for their own lands. The Kurds are an ethnic minority group totaling roughly 25 to 30 million people, all united by a unique race, culture, and language. Although Kurds are the largest ethnic minority in Turkey, making up roughly 20% of the population, they are not recognized as a minority group in Turkey. Today, Kurdistan is made up of five different regions: southeastern Turkey, northeastern Syria, northern Iraq, northwestern Iran, and southwestern Armenia, and is now one of the world's largest stateless nations whose people have no official homeland or country.
Our next story is quite a cute one. 두 번째 뉴스 포커스입니다. 미국 NBC가 생방송으로 터키와 시리아 충돌에 대한 토론을 하던 중에 뉴스 앵커의 아들이 난입하는 방송 사고가 발생했는데요. 2년 전 부산대 로버트 켈리 교수님이 생각나네요. 그때도 영국 BBC랑 생방송 중에 갑자기 딸이 방에 침입해서 유명 인사가 됐었죠. Let's listen to the story.
Sometimes things on a live broadcast go exactly according to plan, but other times anchors are forced to go off script. NBC's Pentagon correspondent Courtney Cube was talking about Turkish airstrikes in Syria when her son appeared live on camera, causing the mom-turned anchor to return to just the role of mom. She later explained that breaking news in Syria didn't line up with the preschool drop-off, so she had to bring her two children to work.
네, 굉장히 귀여운 방송 사고가 미국의 NBC 방송에서 있었습니다. 지금 보이는 라디오로 그 영상 보여드리고 있어요.
Yeah.
그 시리아와 터키 얘기가 지금 굉장히 심각한 뉴스잖아요. 그 얘기를 하고 있던 중에 갑자기 어린 아들이 뛰쳐 들어와가지고 엄마! 그래서
yeah.
이제 뭐 약간 안아달라는 제스처를 하고 있죠.
And she tries for a moment to stay on script.
맞아요. 이게 좀 밀려고 하면서 모르는 채를 몇 초 동안 하다가 결국은 여러분 죄송합니다.
Yeah.
생방송이다 보니까 이제 사과를 해요.
Yeah. We asked the question the other day, how do you know we're live? That's the type of situation when you know you're live. Anyway,
exactly.
Yes. Sometimes anchors are forced to go off script. Well, we this morning have a script.
We do.
Right? And on that, we know that we have News Focus 2 about this live broadcast, and we know we have News Focus 3 coming up about Hanoi. But if something happens, if something goes wrong, then we are forced to abandon the script and kind of create new content, if you will. Let me give you an example. If we are meant to interview someone from America, And that's in the script.
Yep.
But then there's a terrible phone connection and we can't do it. Mm. Well, now we have to come up with new stuff to talk about. Yep. That's going off script.
그렇죠. Go off script. 그러면은 원고의 내용과 다른 얘기를 한다라는 뜻입니다. 여기서는 원고에 당연히 없었겠죠. 이렇게 아들이 뛰쳐 들어오는 게. 그래서 돌발 상황을 얘기합니다.
Yeah, and we can use it to mean a plan that doesn't happen. You had the plan, right? But now you have to do something different.
Okay. And of course, it also says here that the breaking news in Syria didn't line up with the preschool drop-off.
Yeah, so the schedules didn't match. They didn't line up. So she had to, by the sounds of things, because it was breaking news, she had to come in and do this report when she was supposed to take her kids to preschool. Mm-hmm. But the schedule for preschool and the breaking news in Syria, they didn't match, they didn't line up.
네, 뭔가가 이제 딱 들어맞을 때 line-up이라는 표현을 쓸 수 있는데요. 여기서 그 앵커가 나중에 이제 부연 설명으로 굉장히 재치 있게 이런 얘기를 했거든요. 아, 여러분 죄송합니다. 시리아의 뉴스랑 저희 아들들의 등원 시간이랑 잘 들어맞지가 않아가지고 제가 할 수 없이 오늘 방송국에 데려왔는데 이런 일이 발생했네요. 라고 이제 설명을 했다고 해요. Very witty.
Yeah, exactly. And a cute story too,
yes.
right?
Yep, let's listen to this one more time.
Sometimes things on a live broadcast go exactly according to plan, but other times anchors are forced to go off script. NBC's Pentagon's correspondent Courtney Cube was talking about Turkish airstrikes in Syria when her son appeared live on camera, causing the mom-turned anchor to return to just the role of mom. She later explained that breaking news in Syria didn't line up with the preschool drop-off, so she had to bring her two children to work.
One of these days, I feel like I might have to do that too.
Yeah.
You never know.
You never know, right? And I mean, when it happens, you have to understand, of course, right? Mm.
All right. With that said, let's remind our listeners of the quiz.
Mm-hmm. Something especially rare or expensive that is good to eat can be referred to as A, number one, delicacy, or number two, democracy.
네, 짧은 문자 50원, 긴 문자 100원에 샵 1045로 보내주시고요. 반디 게시판이나 카카오톡 플러스 이용도 가능합니다. 추첨을 통해서 총 다섯 분께 저자극 순한 비누 보내드릴게요. Let's listen to Sugar Ray every morning and we'll be right back.
I know it's not mine, but I see it.
자, 세 번째 뉴스 포커스 살펴보겠습니다. 베트남 하노이의 대표적인 관광 명소 가운데 하나인 기찻길 카페가 역사 속으로 사라지게 됐다는데요. Let's listen to the story.
Authorities are clamping down on the cafes that line one of Hanoi's most famous roads, an old quarter thoroughfare known as Train Street, citing over-tourism and safety concerns. Authorities cite danger to human life as the primary motivator for the shutdown. The boiling point apparently came on Sunday, October 6th, when a train traveling through Hanoi was forced to reroute because there were too many tourists on the tracks. The municipal government of Hanoi has ordered that cafes alongside the heavily Instagram train closed by October 12th.
네, 굉장히 유명한 기찻길 카페. 저도 사진으로 많이 봤는데요.
Me too.
This is going to be a thing of the past.
Yeah, tomorrow it's closing. So I guess if you want some pictures for your Instagram, you better go today.
Yes. Tomorrow's 지금 보이는 라디오로 영상을 띄워드리고 있습니다. A very famous spot.
Yeah.
But dangerous, is that what they're
saying? Dangerous, and that's what they said. That the main reason that they gave was, you know, this train traveling through Hanoi, it had to reroute. There were too many tourists on the track. So safety is the main reason here. And as we always say, safety first, right? Although Absolutely. It is very sad because it's so beautiful, isn't it?
It is, yeah. I understand that there was a case not too long ago where the train had to halt operations temporarily because too many people were on the train. And the rail, the tracks weren't sturdy enough to hold such heavy weight.
I see. Mm. Yeah. It's also sad for those businesses right along, the cafes along there as well,
yeah,
because
wow,
their business will inevitably suffer, right?
Mm, it will indeed. All right, let's look at some expressions.
Yes, so this street is a thoroughfare. A thoroughfare is pretty easy. It means a road, a main road, right? And it's known as Train Street. But the reason that they gave is the danger to human life. Authorities cite danger to human life. Mm. And when you cite something, you mention it as proof.
그렇죠. 일단은 thoroughfare 그러면은 굉장히 큰 길, 대로를 뜻하는데 이 경우에는 물론 이제 우리가 생각하는 그런 도심 속에 있는 도로는 아닙니다만 그래도 상점이 굉장히 많이 늘어서 있는 큰 길을 thoroughfare라고 하고요. site 같은 경우에는 보통 뭐 이유를 들다, 아니면 예를 들다 라는 뜻으로 쓰이죠. 뭐 인용하다라는 뜻도 물론 있습니다. 여기서는 이제 왜 이게 역사 속에 사라지게 되느냐에 대해서 당국은 굉장히 위험한 요소가 많다. 너무 오래됐기 때문이다. 라는 얘기를 했습니다.
So this site is not S-I-G-H-T. It's C-I-T-E.
Yes.
And if you are a student and you write a book report, then you have to cite your sources.
Yeah,
right?
Very important.
If you have a quote in your report, you have to cite your source. And also if you're a reporter, right?
Yeah.
Sometimes they want you to cite your source as well.
맞아요. 뉴스에서도 굉장히 많이 나오는 표현이죠. 인용하다, C-I-T-E, cite. And one more expression here. The municipal government of Hanoi has ordered that these cafes and the whole area be closed by October 12th.
Yeah, tomorrow. Yeah. So municipal government, this is relating to a city or a town or its government within that city or town.
So it has to have its own local government. Seoul is not a municipal city. And the municipal 그러면 지방자치의라는 뜻이 있습니다. Let's listen to this story one more time.
A Authorities are clamping down on the cafes that line one of Hanoi's most famous roads, an old quarter thoroughfare known as Train Street, citing over-tourism and safety concerns. Authorities cite danger to human life as the primary motivator for the shutdown. The boiling point apparently came on Sunday, October 6th, when a train traveling through Hanoi was forced to reroute because there were too many tourists on the tracks. The municipal government of Hanoi has ordered that cafes alongside the heavily Instagram train closed by October 12th.
All right, and what's the answer to the quiz?
Quiz question this morning, something especially rare or expensive that is good to eat can be referred to as number one, delicacy, or number two, democracy. The answer is delicacy.
네, 1번이 정답이 되겠습니다. 진소라님, 이정하님, 오인경님, 성연호님, 그리고 옥미선님 축하드립니다. 저자극 순한 비누 보내드릴게요. Steve, what is your expression of the day today?
Expression of the day today is to go off script.
Uh-huh.
Now, we can use it as broadcasters in a literal sense, but you can use this expression too when you have to change your plan. Let's say that you have a first date with a beautiful girl and you are very excited about that date.
Okay.
And you have your plan. You're going to go to the restaurant in Gangnam. And after that, you're going to go to the Bampo Area Park for a nice walk along the river.
How detailed.
Beautiful, right?
Yes.
But you go to the restaurant, and the restaurant is closed that day.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh. So you have to go to a different restaurant.
Uh-huh.
And then you go to the Bampo Park.
Yeah.
But it's under construction for tree planting or something like that. So you had a plan for dinner in the park at the restaurant, and but it didn't go according to plan. You had to go off script. How was your date last night? Yeah, it turned out okay, but I had to go off script because the restaurant was closed I wanted to go to and the park was under construction.
네, 뭔가 이렇게 예정되거나 계획된 대로 하지 않을 때 아니면 되지 않을 때 go off script라는 표현을 쓸 수 있습니다. 방송 같은 경우에는 이제 우리가 ad-lib이라고 해서 즉흥적으로 중간중간 얘기를 많이 하죠. 원고가 물론 있지만 이것만 우리가 읽는 것은 아니고 we do often go off script.
We do, yeah.
지금 이렇게 대화를 나눈 것들도 사실 다 go off script 하는 거잖아요.
Mm-hmm.
그래서 이렇게 즉흥적으로 뭔가 얘기를 하는 것도 go off script고 그 다음에 상황상 예정했던 것과 정 반대로 아니면 너무나 다르게 뭔가가 전개됐을 때도 go off script라는 표현을 쓸 수 있습니다.
I'll give you one easy example too. I grew up in Canada, but I moved overseas. I've spent many years overseas.
Yeah.
I'm a little older, but I'm not married. That's not the normal plan in Western society or even Korean society. So you could say, yeah, my life
has gone off script.
It's gone off script and it continues to go off script and that's the way I want it. I don't like living by the script.
인구 900인 작은 마을 출신인 스티브 헤들리 선생님의 인생이 go off script 했다.
Yes.
이런 얘기를 해주셨어요.
It's way more fun.
예정된 사람들이 보통 생각하는 이 마을의 청년이 살아야 될 길을 살지 않으셨고요. 지금의 이 스티브 헤들리 방송인이라는 위치까지 오신 것 같습니다. Alright, well, we have a very interesting message. And I'd like to introduce this. 굉장히 흥미로운 사연이 하나 들어왔습니다. 사진과 함께요. 안녕하세요. 태교로 모스에 정착한 지 두 달쯤 되는 샤이 청취자입니다. 얼마 전에 근데 아파트 엘리베이터에서 월터쌤과 너무 닮은 백발의 신사를 본 거예요. 에이, 아니겠지 하면서 그때는 그냥 지나쳤는데 어제 아침 글쎄 아파트 앞에서 캐나다 이사 전문 차량이 보이는 거예요. 그리고 이사 박스에는 한글로 월터 이렇게 써 있어서 그분임을 확신했습니다. 아무리 샤이한 저라도 마지막 인사는 건네고 싶어서 처음 뵙는 사이고 모스는 들은 지 두 달밖에 안 되는 청취자지만 사진 좀 찍어도 될까요? 이렇게 요청을 했더니 같이 찍어주셨어요 하셨습니다. This is yesterday.
Yeah.
Nice picture, huh?
네. 20여 년간의 한국 생활을 이제 정리하면서 캐나다 갈 때까지 시간이 좀 필요하셔서 우리 방송은 이제 그만둔 지가 몇 주 됐지만 내일, 오늘인가 내일 출국하시는 걸로 제가 알고 있습니다. 네, 이사, 그 이삿짐을 어제 보내셨나 봐요.
I'm sure he'll be back for sure to visit many, many times. And he'll be back to visit at EBS too. Don't worry about that. That's what a cool story though, huh?
I know.
Yeah.
저도 울터 선생님 방송 이제 그만두신 이후에 개인적으로 몇 번 만났었는데 에, 그 his heart is in Korea. Yeah. 마음만큼은 한국 사람이시더라고요.
And we have Walter's response.
Oh really?
Yeah, we do. He shared it. Sure. It says and again this is from Walter. Thank you for saying hello yesterday. It was great to meet you and you've given me one more amazing story to tell about my 20 plus years in Korea. The time I met a most listener who lives in the same building as me the day before I left the country to return to Canada. If it didn't happen to me personally, I wouldn't have believed it. Thank you also for supporting Morning Special and finally best of luck on the birth of your child. 감사합니다.
네, 정말 감사합니다. 너무 좋은 사연이네요.
Very nice.
Yes, and Walter, if you're listening, safe travels, keep in touch.
Best of luck.
Best of luck.
Come back and visit us, please.
Yes, please do. All right. Well, that wraps up this first hour. Thank you so much, Steve.
You're very welcome. Have a wonderful Friday. We'll see you for the Saturday show.
Absolutely.
Bye-bye.
Taking us into hour two now is Jazztronic with I Like It. I'll be back in hour two.
Thought is you, the things you do seem so satisfying to me. I must confess it, girl.
Ooh, and I like it.
You send chills on my spine every time I take one look at you.
Ooh, and I like it.
Girl, you're blowing my mind with the things you say to me. I like the way you comb your hair, and I like the stylish clothes you wear. It's just the little things you do that show how much you really care. Like when I'm all alone with you, you know exactly what to do. You put the fire inside of me and make it more than just a dream. Thought it's you, the things you told.